Ngee-Ann Secondary has been helmed by an illustrious list of principals who have shaped our education landscape. Our very first principal, Mr. Tan Thiam Hock, 1994 to 1998, blazed a trail for the school that we see today. In his inaugural message, his wish was to make Ngee-Ann Secondary one of the best schools in the eastern part of the Republic, where no effort should be spared to make sure our academic development, extracurricular activities, and pastoral care programs were well planned and efficiently implemented. This strong vision that he had is something that we still see today, in how his words and deeds have shaped the lives of many teachers under his leadership, and scores of students who have been nurtured into able, valuable individuals, capable of accomplishing high standards of achievement. And this story continues in how our next educator has shaped our education landscape in Ngee-Ann Secondary School.
For every teacher, no matter how long their service is, as a teacher, we have fulfilled our responsibility and the duty to teach, to guide our students.
Back then, is the issues that students present themselves with when they come to school. Back then, I remember that main issues will be getting students to come to school, coming to school on time, and having their necessary books. That was a major issue that we faced at that time.
In the past, education pathways were more direct, but right now the education landscape has actually changed quite a lot because there are actually a lot of possibilities. Students can actually opt to go to polytechnics or ITEs at an earlier stage after they have identified their areas of interest.
As educator, we need to be a parent, we need to be a multitasker, event planner, a friend, a counselor. It's like really providing a holistic education for our students today.
Back then, the teachers used to be very strict, like ensured their lessons were fun, interesting, and meaningful.
I think every teacher inspired me in one way or another. But if I have to name one person, it would be Madam Ashikin, because she really spent a lot of time with me outside the classroom and showed me the human side to teaching.
I hope the education system will bring out more hidden talents of our students, which will allow them to actually choose any career path they like in the future.
Values like self-discipline, resilience, perseverance are values that transcend time and age. Generations with generations, we educators are emphasizing on all these values because we know these are values that will hold fast throughout our students' life.
To me, I think that excellence is a value that all the students will pick up from their school education. In their many years of education in school, they all have been guided to excellence. So when they go into the society, the changes of society to become excellent society.
As we continue on this journey together, let us remember to look back and appreciate how far we have come, as well as look forward to the future and embrace the rich array of opportunities presented to us.